In this video, I'm going to do a comparison between Windsor and Toronto regarding the average purchase prices and average rents and expenses in general. Namaskar, Adabarse, Vanakkam, Sashrikal, good morning, good evening, what's up guys? So, welcome back to my channel. If you still haven't hit that subscribe button, hit it right now for an awesome content regarding real estate and some financials and my own journey and all sort of, you know, PS. So, as I mentioned, today I'm going to do some comparisons between Toronto and Windsor. I just want to share my thoughts on having advantages in living in a smaller city with this comparison. And again, I don't want to make this as an argument or anything that Windsor is the best life to be in, but again, I just want to throw some shadow on why it makes sense whether to live or invest in smaller cities that are up and coming rather than already a solid established cities like Toronto. So that's the only intention. Please also share your ideas in the comments below so I know if what we are talking, you know, if I have the right thinking or not. So please comment below. Let me know your thoughts always. So first of all, I'll start off with a purchase prices. Average purchase prices for a single family homes in Toronto is 800,000 plus. You heard it right, 800,000 plus for a single family home in Toronto. Whereas in Windsor, the single family average home price is 300 plus. So again, I'll display on the screen with the exact numbers, but it's over 300. See the difference. Where is 300? Where is 800? There is a big difference. If you own a house in Toronto for 800,000, your monthly payment, just the mortgage payment, based on 2.8 interest rate. Again, I don't wanna, you know, please comment below about specifics, but I'm not really great at that every specific number, but it's average 3,420 something. Whereas for a 300,000 property, average monthly payment, mortgage payment is 1450 something. So you see the difference? 1500, 3500. There is a 2000 difference. And again, you have some more expenses like property taxes, insurance, water bill, hydro, gas, blah, blah, blah. So that those on an average $1,000 in Windsor. In Toronto, I would say 1200 because your property taxes are for 800,000 house is much higher when compared to 300,000 house. So if you want to survive when something happens to the market here, you need 5,000, just not even survive, just to keep this house. And here you need 2500 to keep this house. And average rents for a one bedroom house in Toronto is $1,247. In Windsor, $1,000, 40, 50 or something, $1,000 on an average. So if you have one bedroom in your basement here and here, you can get here $1,200 and here you get $1,000. So pretty much exactly in my house. So my expenses gone down from 2,500 to 1,500. Here, you're still your expenses from 5,000 to 4,000. So you still have that difference. So again, if you have great jobs in Toronto, great income and all those things, that's awesome. Make sure you add some additional sources for the house, just not to depend on just the salary alone, because that's the people who are gonna be hit hard when something happens with the market. Because that's been the talk been happening for a while. That's why I'm making this video, just to make you aware. You know, if you're thinking of buying a house, but you're just depending on your salary, and if your salary is less, I strongly suggest not to go for bigger houses. You know, look for something that is affordable. Look for something, you know, in affordable areas. You know, if you still have to rent out in Toronto, have a house in Windsor, just to make sure you have an asset which is growing over years. So the growth in Toronto was much higher compared to Windsor because the Toronto market is much bigger, but in last 1-2 years, the market rates kind of stabilized. But people who purchased in 2007, 8, 9, 10, they saw a huge appreciation. And whereas in Windsor now, in 2016, until 2016, the property prices were really low. From 2016, they started to go up. Like, you know, the average prices of house in 2016 was like 180,000 and went up 220, 240. Now it's 300. So the appreciation is happening in Windsor, and we are still only we are coming from the recession, like 2016. So 2017, 18, 19, only 3 years. There is, I see, based on what's happening in Windsor, I see it can continue for another couple of years based on things that I'm seeing here. I will be making another video on what's happening here. But just to compare, yes, Windsor is a great market. I would never ever argue on that point. But, you know, you need to have much higher, you know, what do you call that, the upfront cost and holding cost. If you are just depending on the salaries, I really urge you to double think, rethink, and whatever, you know, safe for you. Play it safely rather than blindly looking at others. You know, if my friend is buying this property, my cousin is buying that property, I'm going to go buy it and live in it. No, just before you make those kind of dumb mistakes, first of all, think about yourself. You know, if you have money, if your dad made millions of dollars or you made millions of dollars, man, live that beautiful life. Yes, buy an awesome house or buy a dream home because you worked hard and you made it. But if you're just depending on the salary or just depending on something, you know, makes you only few thousand, double think. Don't get excited by looking at others. Don't get excited and buy properties on emotion, because that can kill you. That can kill your dreams, your kids' dreams, because, you know, at one point after in a stage of life, money is more precious. Like you have to spend in a right place rather than in a wrong place. I see that just the mortgage and living in it is a liability. So when it's a liability, think it. Even though if you can have a huge appreciation, I don't know if it's going to happen, but it's already at $1 million in Toronto, whereas in Windsor, you still have that room for appreciation. So rethink. Again, guys, these are my thoughts based on from what I have seen. I'm gonna put the links below for all the stats where I pull the average rents. It's rentboard.ca for Toronto, toronto.ca, and you know, Windsor board for the average prices and Toronto board for average prices. I'll put all the links in the description so you can cross verify all those details. Make some educated decisions based on what's happening in the market. So this is what my observation, and I wanna hear from you guys. And also, guys, let me know what kind of content you like to hear from me, what kind of topics you want me to talk in later videos. I would like to hear your thoughts. So that I can navigate my content accordingly, so that it is useful for you rather than I'm just talking all BS. I don't want that to, you know, even waste my time on things that doesn't matter for others. So that's why please leave a comment below what kind of, you know, content can help you from me. So let me know. And also, one thing I'm gonna shout out regarding our upcoming event. If you're looking to invest or buy properties in Windsor, we are starting a WinCity tour. So we're gonna show a couple of off-market deals from the last Saturday of this month, and it's gonna continue every last Saturday of every month. So this upcoming event is on September 28th. I'm gonna leave the link below. We have a small fees for the bus tour because we have to rent the bus and we provide some lunch and all those things. So you will get a chance to meet other investors, local, and also following once the bus tour is done, we have a networking event as well, where we have speakers come up talking about different strategies and all those things. So make sure you check out those links below. And if you're coming to the event, let me know in the description, let me know in the comments. I love to meet you in person and love to see you all, guys. Thank you very much for the support. My channel is getting close to 1,000 subscribers. Please share with your friends if you think this content is helpful, and we'll catch you up in the next video. Until then, you can check out other videos here. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.